So we are sitting here now in the break of CD recording in the MCO studios. This is a project that I'm very excited about. I kind of hoped my entire life that I might be able to start accompanying also singers because of the amazing and wonderful repertoire there is. I'm doing this with my dear friend and wonderful baritone Thomas Oliemans.
Florestan and Eusebius were two characters which Schumann used himself, but about the same time there was a book written about Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Dr. Jekyll creates a kind of potion, an alchemist potion, and transforms himself into Mr. Hyde. Mr. Hyde is a killer. He's a very, very bad person in the end. Florestan and Eusebius, as we know, are two characters of Schumann in a way, which represent the more thoughtful, maybe Dr. Jekyll kind of thinking of contemplation, and Florestan the more draufgängerisch, you would say in German. And these are things which we hear a lot in Schumann. But suddenly I thought the later Schumann, the later years, the end we know Schumann had, going mad or losing his mind, trying to commit suicide, is more of a Mr. Hyde kind of atmosphere. And that's how the idea came about to combine Dichterliebe, which is considered by everybody as his big song masterpiece, or one of the few big masterpieces and song, with the later cycles, which are performed much less, of 1850, opus 89 and opus 90.
Vind je het zachte de laatste?
Ja.
Misschien dat je, dat is te gek die op die woord
versteekt.
En dan kan het piano met nog niet zo'n ruimte hebben misschien.
Deine tiefe.
And to separate, to try to accentuate and to separate these worlds even more, we use two beautiful instruments which are right behind me.
One is a Graf piano of around 1830, and the other one is a Streicher grand piano from around 1840. And thus you can also see in this period how much the piano was also changing. I mean, the piano of one decade was not the same as the other one. And at the same time, these were the pianos that Schumann encountered, that Schumann also had at his home, and that inspired him in making this incredible music.
We're now in the middle of recording on the Streicher. We've done last few days on the Graf already, which is the more delicate one. You can see also by the build of it. What's interesting with the more delicate one, with the Graf, it also has a moderator, which can really change the sound. Schubert had it in his time, but on the Streicher it is gone. So in our recording of Dichterliebe, we use it also, which gives a very uncommon quality for us being used to big Steinway or Yamaha. And then suddenly you get a whole different world of sounds, just because Paolo does what he always does, which is playing beautifully. But certain colors suddenly strike out, which force me or which invite me to rethink and to sing differently as well. Tempo-wise, sometimes breath-wise, it gets very different. So that's a really exciting journey.
I hope that this will add to this very specific and intimate and wondrous world.
Das ist der Mensch. rechte Ort für dein schmerzliches Verzichten. Grauer Vogel in den Zweigen, einsam deine Klage singt und auf deine Frage bringt Antwort nicht des Waldes Schweigen, wenn's auch immer schweigt.